My dear brothers and sisters, I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before I ask Him. I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He guided us to the religion of Islam. And I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and send all praise to Him that He made us from the Ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is the best Ummah. Allah said, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. Allah said, you are and you were and you will, this is the translation, are the best Ummah among us all the nations. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this very choose to the Ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night that we weren't from any other nation, even we weren't from people who follow Isa on the right path. We thank Allah we are from the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We thank Allah that we are not from those who follow Musa alayhi salam. He make us better. So alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He guided us to come to this place and to sit here and to listen to this lecture and to learn, all of us, speaker and listener. I ask Him to make us close and neighbors to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Jannat al-Firdaus. And we are sitting tonight for the love of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because we love Him. We are sitting in this night to take some stories, to learn some stories, some seers of the best man that Allah Azza wa Jalla created him. The nur that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him in the darkness. So alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Brothers and sisters, this is one of the most important lectures that maybe you will take it in your life. So please listen carefully from where I start until I finish, inshallah. In this lecture, I will speak about the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, since he was born or before that until when he passed the way sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we will speak about his family first, then how he was born, then his childhood, then his youth time, then when he became a man before a da'wah, before the message, then when Allah Azza wa Jal sent him, then how he got married, then how he migrated, or before migration, how he suffered, then how he migrated, then how he made a Hajj, then how he defended Islam and Muslims in Medina, then how he made the agreements, then how he went the Hajj, and how he dies after that. So his name is Muhammad ibn Abdullah, ibn Abd al-Muttalib, ibn Hashim, ibn Abd Manaf, ibn Qusay, ibn Kilab, ibn Murra. Ibn Adnan, ibn Ismail, ibn Ibrahim alayhi salam. That's his name. When you look at this names or at these names, Allah gave him the best families. He came from the best families. So his father is Ismail and his grandfather is Ibrahim alayhi salam. That's why Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to say, my father Ibrahim. My father Ibrahim. And he used to say, I am the da'wah. I came here and Allah sent me because I am, was a dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam. So as what I started in my khutbah today, I don't want to start from the time of Ibrahim, because I will start then giving a lecture of Al-Hajj. I'm going to give a lecture then of Ismail and how Ismail came with his mother. So it will take long time from us, inshallah. When Al-Hajj comes, before Al-Hajj, we will speak about that. So I will start from where I started exactly in my khutbah. I started today from my khutbah from his fourth grandfather. Or second grandfather, sorry. The fourth man that Prophet ﷺ belonged to him. His name is Muhammad bin Abdullah bin Abd al-Muttalib bin Hashim bin Abd Manaf. So I will start from Abd Manaf to give you the lecture. Before that, I have to tell you something. His name is Muhammad. How many Muhammads? How many brothers? His name is Muhammad. Muhammad al-Bal, Muhammad Shakir, mashallah. Muhammad. Tabarak al-Rahman. Very nice, Muhammad. Okay. What is the meaning of the name of Muhammad? Muhammad means the man that he gathers the perfect manners and attributes. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His grandfather is Abdul Manaf, was born, sorry, got married from a woman, from the best woman in Arab. Her name is Salma. And Allah gifted him Hashim. And it's not just Hashim, and another two boys. One of them, his name is Al-Muttalib. Hashim. His name was not Hashim. What was his name? I said that in my khutbah today. Amr. Hashim is kunya. Arab, they used to tell people sometimes by their acts. If he's a, let's say, person, a liar person, they would say, this is the liar. They name him like this. Hashim, it's not his name. His name is Amr. Amr bin Abdi Manaf. They called him Hashim because he was a very generous man. What he was doing, he used to prepare the bread and the meat, and he used to smash them, to mix them together. And he used to give it to al-Hujjaj, people who come for al-Hajj. Because al-Hajj was from Ibrahim alayhi salam. Al-Islam renew al-Hajj. Al-Islam put some new rules of al-Hajj. But al-Hajj started from when? From the time of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Before what? Before Musa alayhi salam and before Isa. People used to go to al-Hajj. Allah said what? وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا. Allah said that to Ibrahim alayhi salam. So he used to host and reception and receive al-Hujjaj. People come for Hajj and he used to give them from his wealth. He was a very generous man. So they call him Hashim. Hashim got married to from his cousin. She was one of the best women in Arab. And Allah gifted him one boy. They called him Abdul Muttalib. They called him Abdul Muttalib. All of your phones has to be silent now. Make sure from your phone. They called him عبد المطلب، هاشم. Allah gifted him a son. They called him عبد المطلب, right? He's the grandfather of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. But his name wasn't عبد المطلب. What was his name? شيبة الحمد. عبد المطلب, his name was شيبة الحمد. Why they called him عبد المطلب? It will come, inshallah, in the story. Listen, I will ask at the end, especially my students. So they called him عبد المطلب, not شيبة الحمد. Why? Because عبد المطلب, when Allah gifted هاشم عبد المطلب, then هاشم passed away immediately. So عبد المطلب grew up as an orphan. He was orphan. So his mother from where? From Al-Madinah, not from Mecca. Can you make it silent, please? Silent, please. So, his name is عبد المطلب. If anyone now his phone will ring, I will tell you, leave the majlis immediately. So, his name is عبد المطلب. عبد المطلب grew up with his mother. When his father passed away, she took him to Al-Madinah, to Bani Adi. Bani Adi, where? They lived in Al-Madinah. She went back to her family. He grew up there. What was his name? What was his name, عبد المطلب? شيبة الحمد. So he grew up in Al-Madinah. Then his uncle, what's his uncle name? His father is Hashim. What's his uncle name? His father is Amr al-Muttalib. He said, I have to go and bring my nephew here. He has to grow up with us. He went to Al-Madinah and he brought عبد المطلب. When he entered to Mecca, when he brought عبد المطلب, what happened? People in Mecca saw Al-Muttalib with a young man. They said Al-Muttalib brought a slave. They called him Abd, means a slave. Slave of Al-Muttalib. عبد المطلب. He told him, no. This is my nephew. This is the son of my brother, Hashim. He's not a slave. But they called him عبد المطلب and became common name for him. عبد المطلب means a slave of المطلب. عبد المطلب grew up in Mecca until became the chief of Mecca. When he became the chief of Mecca, Allah gave him two beautiful signs. Listen carefully. The first one, he was walking. And he stepped on Zamzam. And he hit the land with his foot. So subhanAllah, he found the sound that there was the wall here. It was the wall of Zamzam. What happened to the wall of Zamzam exactly? When Hajar found the wall of Zamzam, and who was the one who opened the wall of Zamzam? So Ismail found the water, but who was the who opened the wall of Zamzam? Do you know who? Who? So it was Jibreel alayhi salam. Jibreel opened the wall. So Ismail hit the land. The water came out. His mother, Zamzam, by her language, Zamzam means what?
Stop.
Make it stay here, the water. Okay? Let's cover the place for the water. She's trying to make it to make a pool, but it was a well. So what happened? It was a well. So what happened? If Jibreel alayhi salam came and he entered that. Then Jurhum came. Listen carefully. This is the best history for Islam. Jurhum, a tribe, came and they sat there when they found the water because they were looking for water. Jurhum were Arabun Ariba. Arabun Ariba means what? Original of Arab. They found the water and they asked permission from Hajar. They said, can we stay here? She said, yes, you can stay here. Ismail was not Arab and wasn't speak Arabic language, but he learned Arabic language from Jurhum. And he got married from Arab women. That's why his children became Arab. But when Jurhum left Mecca, they closed this wall. Until the time of Abdul Muttalib. So Abdul Muttalib found this water, Zamzam. He hit the land and he heard the voice or the sound of the land. He told his people, let's open this. They said no. And in that time, if you want people to follow you, you have to have what? A strong family. You have to have a strong sons and boys. And that time he had only one boy. What happened? He told and he asked Allah, he said, Ya Allah, give me 10 boys. And if you give me 10 boys, I will slaughter one of them for the sake of you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua and he put him in test. He accepted his dua and he gave him 10 boys. So when he had 10 boys, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him permission. So he opened that well and became Zamzam. Then he has to what? He has to work for his promise. He has to slaughter one son. So Allah gave him 10 boys. One of these 10 boys who? Abdullah. Who was Abdullah? Abdullah was the father of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was the most beloved son to him. Abd al-Muttalib, Shaybat al-Hamd, his name is Shaybat al-Hamd, not Abd al-Muttalib. They called him Abd al-Muttalib. He said, if they tell me, slaughter your 9 boys or keep this one, I will slaughter them. See how much he was loving Abdullah. And Abdullah had a very nice manners. He got married, Abdullah, from one of the best women in Arab. She was his cousin, Salma. So he got married from this woman. Sorry, Abdullah got married from Amina ibn Wahb. She was his cousin, she was the best woman in Arab. But before to tell you, Abdullah, how he was, I have to finish the story. Abdul Muttalib has what? Has to work on his promise. He has to slaughter his son, but he can't. They told him, go and ask, there is a woman in Medina, Arrafa, fortunate tiller. They said, go to her and ask her. She went to him. He went to her and he said, this is my story. Allah gifted me 10 boys. Now I have to slaughter one of them. So when I made the choice between them, Oh, three times Abdullah comes, his name, and I don't want to slaughter him. What should I do? She said, every time when his name comes, you have to pay or you have to give 10 camels until to pick or until to see the camels only, not your son Abdullah. Now he took his sons out, the 9 of his sons out, and he just put Abdullah or 10 camels. The name of Abdullah comes. So, now the first 10, second time, Abdullah or another 10 camels, Abdullah, until 10 times, until he has to pay how much? He has to slaughter 100 camels. Then after that, the name of camels came. When he has to slaughter hundreds, the name of hundreds camels came. So he slaughtered 100 camels to protect his son Abdullah. And he will not do that. He was not do that if one of his other sons. Now what happened after that? When Allah protected Abdullah, his father was loving him so much, so he chose the best woman in Arab area, in all Arab area. Her name is Amina bint Wahb, his cousin, and she was so beautiful, and she was one of the best Arab that has manners and high rank. He went and he did marriage. He write a contract for her, and he did what? And he gave her mahar, marriage. That time, the most of the relation between men and women, out of marriage. The marriage before, some men, they marry only one woman. And some women, they divorce, not divorce, they just give their wives to each other. Or they have a relation with another woman without any contract, without any marriage, and they have a children from them. Prophet ﷺ was out of all of this. Alhamdulillah. Prophet ﷺ was a son of marriage, was a son of nikah. Alhamdulillah. His mother Amina got pregnant from his father Abdullah. Abdullah was a businessman. He left to Palestine, exactly to Gaza, for tijara. But he got sick there, and Amina was pregnant in the 6th month. Of who? Of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Abdullah got sick there, and when he went to come back to Mecca, he couldn't reach Mecca, so he stayed in Medina. With who? With his uncles, because his mother from Medina. So he stayed with his uncles because he was so sick. Then he passed away. So his grave in Medina until now, but they hide it now. Why? Because people just before 100 century, 80 years, they used to go and they used to visit his grave. And they used to do some shirk, wal'iyadu billah. They used to worship him because they said this is the grave of the father of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is in Medina. But they hide now his grave, not just for one reason, they don't want people to worship him or to do something haram. What happened after that? He passed away. The news came to who? To Amina bint Wahb, and she was pregnant. After 2 months, she delivered her son. Before to deliver her son, when she was pregnant, She saw a dream, not a dream, رؤيا. There is difference between a dream. Dream based on two things. One truth dream, we call it رؤيا. And one untruth dream, we call it's a regular dream from a shaitan, when you eat too much. But رؤيا, when it happens, subhanAllah, it will be true. So, she saw Amina and her dream that Noor, light, Noor comes out from her stomach and what? Went immediately to Ash-Sham until the castles, until Qusur, until the castles of Ash-Sham became lightness. She could see in her dream the castles of Ash-Sham in Palestine and Syria, that area. So she was a pregnant, but without any what? Without any fatigue and tiredness. She delivered him without any pain. Where did she deliver him? She delivered him in Bayt al-Mawlid or Bayt al-Milad, the birthplace. Mecca, they used to have a small place. That place was for who? For Muhammad ibn Yusuf al-Thaqafi. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born, and that place still exists until now. But now they change it to public library. If you go to Jihad area, a Jihad area in Mecca, you will find a public library. When you enter there is a small room. They will tell you, Huna wulida Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Here Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. I don't know if you visited this place or not. In Jihad. Then, when he was born, and that night was the night of 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal, from the Fil year, from Aam al-Fil, it was Monday. Second sign now for Abd al-Muttalib. I told you the first sign. What was the first sign? Zamzam. Second sign for his grandfather was what? That year, Abraha al-Habashi wants to destroy a Kaaba because he built a huge church. And he wants people to come, he wanted people to come to worship, to do their worship there. Nobody came there, and he found an old house. People used to travel, suffer, putting themselves in risk just to reach that place. And he said, what? I will destroy this place. So when he decided to destroy Al-Kaaba, he came, and I know you know the story. I don't want to go deeply, just I'm giving you the second sign. He met Abraha, and Abraha came, Abdul Muttalib, and he told him, at the gate of Mecca, Abraha said, did you come here to negotiate with me? He said, no. I just came here for my camels. Your soldiers took 200 camels from me. Your soldiers took 200 camels from me. He said, what? You are the chief of Mecca. Instead to speak about Mecca and asking me to stop, you're asking about your camels? I will give you your camels. What about the Kaaba? He said, I am the Lord of these camels. Lord here in Arabic language means I am the guardian. I am the shepherd. I am the owner of these camels. And he told him one wisdom. لِلْبَيْتِ رَبٌ يَحْمِينَ. And Al-Kaaba, he told him Al-Kaaba, which is Al-Bayt, has a Lord, and the Lord will protect it. Then he commands his people and he say, leave. We don't want to fight him. And he came to Al-Ka'bah, Abdul-Muttalib, and he said, oh my Lord, I protected my camels. Oh my Lord, protect your house. And he left. Then you know the story what happened. And this is the second sign of Abdul-Muttalib. How Allah Azza wa Jalla destroyed Abraha. The night when Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was born in Abraha, sorry, Abdul-Muttalib, his grandfather, saw a dream, ru'ya, angel came to him and he said, you will have a son and name him Muhammad and he will be the best of people. When he woke up, immediately Umm Ayman, Baraka, her name is Baraka. Remember this name because I will mention this name after too. Baraka, Umm Ayman, came to Abdul Muttalib and she said, give me the gift of the good news. He said, what happened? She said, Amina, Amina delivered boy, and he was like a moon, and Allah created him with a complete body, and he doesn't need even circumcision. And she said, exactly, his face as a moon. Abdul-Muttalib cried. Why? Because he saw the dream and he loves his son Abdullah, and Abdullah passed away. So immediately he went to Amina and he said, oh Amina, name him Muhammad. I saw that in my dream. A man came to me and he said, name him Muhammad and he will be the best of people. And another riwayah, the best of Arab. So she named him Muhammad and she gave him breastfeeding and he was orphaned. Amina bint Wahb wasn't the woman that she can give so much milk. She cannot give breastfeeding. And she wanted to give him that, but there is no milk. So she asked another woman, her name is Tawbah. Tawbah is the servant of his uncle Abu Lahab. Tawbah gave him a breastfeeding and also gave a breastfeeding to his uncle Hamza. I will ask this question. She gave a breastfeeding to his uncle Hamza too. So he used to have the milk, he and his uncle. So his uncle Hamza became what? Became his brother from breastfeeding. But Tawbah, something happened to her and she could not give more breastfeeding. Same time, Halima Sa'idiyya was with a few women. They come from Medina to Mecca to bring the children who got 2 years and to take another kids who needs breastfeeding.